Hi everyone, and welcome to the channel. In this video, we'll be building a drip irrigation system. Of all the homemade systems I've seen, this one is by far my favorite because with this one, we can control the drip rate. We can set this system up in just a few minutes and provide water to our plants for multiple weeks.
For this project, we will need a plastic bottle, scissors, a second smaller plastic bottle, cloth or fabric, and tinfoil. To get started, we will be taking our bigger plastic bottle and cutting it in half to separate the top and bottom. We only need the bottom section. I'm cutting 8 to 10 centimeters up from the very bottom of this bottle, and that is going to work great. Next, we will prepare our second bottle. This bottle is smaller so that it can fit inside of that bigger base that we just cut. Take note of where your bottles line up inside of each other, and mark a spot 2 to 3 centimeters down below the top of your base bottle. In this spot on the smaller bottle, we will need to create a hole. You can cut it, drill it, melt it, it doesn't matter, but we need a small hole here, maybe half the size of a penny. The only thing that's critical about this hole is that it will sit below the upper limit of your base bottle. Next, we will get ourselves a bit of tin foil. I'm preparing about 6 inches of foil here, which will be plenty. Our tinfoil is going to wrap around some sort of cloth or fabric. I'm using some scrap cotton fabric I had, but you can use a wide variety of fabrics and make this work. You'll want to choose a fabric that can easily absorb and hold onto water. Once we have a thin piece of fabric prepared, we can roll it into the tinfoil. You can pinch and twist the tinfoil to lock everything into place. The cloth is going to transport water as a result of capillary action, and the tinfoil is going to allow us to easily direct the cloth and adjust the rate that water can flow through it. We need loose cloth to emerge from one end of our tinfoil roll. I'm cutting my cloth at the other end. At this point, our system is set up and we just need water. We'll want to put our foil cloth into our base bottle with the loose cloth end inside of the bottle. We can fill this bottle partially with water, soaking the exposed cloth. Then we'll take our smaller bottle and we want to cover the hole we made in it while we fill it with water. Put the lid back onto that bottle and then put the bottle into your base. When the hole of the small bottle is below the water line in the base, a vacuum will form, stopping the small bottle from draining. This only works though when the lid is secured atop the small bottle. And voila, we have done it. It will take some time for water to travel through your cloth and start dripping, but once it starts, it will drip continuously until all the water is gone from your bottles. One thing we need to ensure is that our bottle system is higher than the soil and plant we want to irrigate. Water will not flow up to a plant that is higher than the system. Once you have a constant drip coming through, you can tighten the tin foil to adjust the flow of water. You can slow down your drip rate, making the system last considerably longer. I'm able to get drip intervals between 10 seconds and 2 minutes. You can get this system to provide drip irrigation for multiple weeks if you slow the drip or use bigger bottles. This setup will work with any sized bottle and is easiest to create when your base bottle is larger than your inner bottle. Here, I have used a 1-liter base bottle and a 591 milliliter inner bottle.